Good evening, everyone. I welcome on behalf of IBS to this webinar. My name is Dr. Vipin Khurana. I'm here joined by my team members, Mr. Jatin Tandon, Mr. Mohit Pawar from IBS. Can you kindly confirm if you can hear my voice and also if you can see the screen, IBSAT analysis webinar on your screen? Thanks, Ashutosh. Few more can confirm if you can see the screen, IBSAT analysis webinar. We'll be having the interaction in question and answer. Kindly switch to question and answer instead of chat. Everyone kindly switch to question and answer. We are in the question and answer window. Kindly confirm if you can hear my voice. We are beginning with the session. Okay, let's begin. Welcome once again on this Thanksgiving Day. I thank you all for joining us in the webinar. Initially, we have some information for you related to IBSAT. So we would like to share that information with everyone. And also simultaneously, in case if you have any queries, you can write those queries, but we would appreciate that kindly listen to the information and also watch it on the screen, and then we'll take your queries simultaneously. So IBSAT is IBS admission test, which is a computer-based test, and it will be held for 20 days window. So on any day of your comfortable choice between 10th to 31st December, across 100 centers in India, you can give that examination. This is a single examination for 9 business schools across India. You can take this test at around 100 centers of any of your choice. The IBSAT test pattern, the time allocated is 2 hours. Total number of questions, there would be 140 that are expected to attend. Total marks allocated would be 140. That is, whatever score you'll have, you'll get out of 140. Means marking scheme, 1 mark for each question. There will be 4 sections within that complete question paper of 2 hours. And for every question, you'll find 5 options, A, B, C, D, and E. It is very important to note that there'll be no negative marking. Hence, we would like to encourage you to apply your approximation skills, your guesstimates, guess plus estimate, and then try to attempt each and every question. These sections, that 4 sections include verbal ability. There will be having 50 questions. Kindly note, in verbal ability, we have 50 questions. In all other sections, that is reading comprehension, quantitative aptitude, data adequacy and data interpretation, there are 30 questions each. To have a quick idea about how to handle it, the tentative hint is that you can divide total 2 hours into 4 equal parts of half an hour each, so that we can you can try to complete each section in half an hour. Verbability, 50 questions you can try to complete in half an hour, and also another sections also you can try to complete in half an hour. We'll have more details on this, but before that, about the marks and cutoffs, since there is no negative marking, so you should try to attempt all. Here, one thing is very important in comparison to some other examination test, that there are no sectional cutoffs, right? You would encourage that if you are brilliant in one section and not so good in another, so you'll get that advantage of your strong points, and hence your overall score out of 140 will matter. There are no sectional time cutoffs, and every question is of 1 mark. The IBSAT examination is a qualifying examination. Once you clear that, then the selection process would be very important. There your score will matter more rather than IBSAT alone, because IBSAT, once you clear, you all will stand at one place, right? So any mark above the qualifying mark, you will stand at the same place. Then the final selection process will be held from 18 to 26th of February at Hyderabad. This will include group discussion and personal interview. This will have a weightage of 60%. Group discussion will have a weightage of 30%. Personal interview will have a weightage of 30%. Plus your performance in academics, in graduation, in 12th and 10th will also matter. Graduation, we keep a weightage of 16%. 12th, we keep a weightage of 12%. And 10th, we keep a weightage of 12%. So if you qualify IBSAT, that means you are already evaluated out of 40 marks based on your academic performance till now. And if you are in the final year, then we'll consider your marks till second year. So after qualifying IBSAT, evaluation out of 60% or 60 marks will be left, and we'll share your score after that GD and PI round in the selection letter. Now, many of you are asking about the IBSAT test, one mock test of all of you have already given. You can expect the IBSAT examination. Vasundha is asking this question, how is the paper for IBSAT expected this year? So you can expect the paper as a mix of easy, moderate, tough and very tough level of questions. It will be quite similar to what you already attempted in the IBSAT mock test. So that is about overall difficulty level. So you can simultaneously reply me if you are okay with this about the difficulty level. Some of you may write yes. Then moving further about the test taking strategy, right? Sometimes students get confused if there is no planning. So that planning is important so that you are in your comfort zone and your stress level is very limited. So test taking strategy, I would recommend that you attempt your strong section first. If you think you are strong in verbal ability, in reasoning, in reading comprehension or data analysis and interpretation, so you choose your section and complete that section first. And since there are no sectional cutoffs, so if you are able to score more marks in one section of your own strong area, that will pay you in the overall score. Then within a section, this is about choosing a section, then within a section, Sagar Mishra, you are not able to hear, no sound. Anyone else? Are other able to hear? Kindly confirm. Sagar, please check. Yeah, there are many who are saying they are able to hear. Sagar, kindly check that your audio connectivity is proper. Most of you are saying yes, so hence I'm moving on. Sagar, kindly check your... Thanks, Sadhvi. Thanks, Gundeep. Thanks, everyone, for saying yes. So we continue with our IBSAT test taking strategy. Thanks, Swaroop, too. Within a section, then, once you have chosen with the strong part, so you complete that section, then within a section, try to identify easier questions, especially in quantitative aptitude, especially in data interpretation. You may be more comfortable with pie chart, or you may be more comfortable with line chart, or you may be more comfortable with data sufficiency in questions. So you can begin with them, right? And then attempt that part and then move to other questions. And then you can try to keep on eliminating that if some question you think may consume more time, so move on, right? Or keep it pending. Do not stuck on a question, that is very important. don't be fuzzy that you're not able to solve this, so it's an ego issue or you must solve this. That's not the time to work on this like this, because time is very limited. Time optimization will pay you a lot. 50 questions of probability. Do not spend more than 30 minutes at all, right? Even if there are 50 questions, we expect that you complete them in even less than 30 minutes and then save some time for quantitative aptitude or data interpretation. Be aware of the negative marking. In IBSAT, there is no negative marking at all. So hence, we encourage that you apply guess plus estimate, that is guesstimate. Use all your approximation skills and attempt each and every question. You may miss, you may move on to your preferred questions, preferred areas by skipping few questions initially, but later on come back for a few moments and then apply your guesstimate. And throughout that 2 hours duration, stay focused. Do not think of that others are able to attempt more and you're not able to attempt so much, which may not be true. It may be just your perception. Finally, important would be, what is the final result? So these are the few tips I want to give about the test taking strategy. Then, since you have already attempted a mock test, you would be very keen to understand how that should have been attempted and how you could have scored maximum marks. So to have just a quick analysis of that IBSAT test, I'm having the question paper here with me. So if in case you have, so you can also try to review that. If we look into the section 1, probability, then you'll notice within section 1, there are some parts, part 1, part 2, part 3. These include synonyms, antonyms, and word relation, right? So either you know them or you don't know them. If immediately it comes to your mind, kindly attempt it. Otherwise, don't be fuzzy. Don't apply so much mind on this to think upon what should be, what should be, what should be, right? So attempt it at first, and then if you want to keep some pending, keep it pending. Within 5 minutes, I would recommend that first 15 questions, you should be through. If you know it, even if you are, in this, out of 5 questions, at first, if you are able to attempt even 1 to 2 questions, right? Feel good on this and move on. Then comes the fourth part of this, that includes the best fit, and then some errors. Here, I would recommend that you apply your common sense and then understanding of English language, your probability. And then here, you can apply some time in each and every part, from fourth part till ninth part, even up to tenth part. You'll find that all these parts, including the best fit, including one word substitution, then including a situation into a sequence and identifying the errors and identifying the parts of a sentence containing error, you'll notice that by spending a little time, you are able to handle it. Swarup, I'm coming to your question. Your question is, what is the length of RC passage? Reading comprehension passage. The reading comprehension passage will not be more than one page. It will be rather somewhere half a page or maximum 500 words. You can consider this. And in reading comprehension passage, since first, I'll come to you. Kindly wait for a few seconds. Then in verbal ability, I'm not recommending any special order. Kindly keep this in mind. You should not work for that ninth part or tenth part. You should apply first. Kindly go continuously, and then later on you can come back. So that is about section one, verbability. And I'll appreciate. Kindly hold on with your questions. I'll answer all of them, Rishabh. questions are mostly factual or inferential. This will vary from section to section, right? In reading comprehension, you will not find any passage more than 500 words, right? So coming to some tips for section 2, I hope you can see the screen also, section 2 RC reading comprehension passage. So some tips include that all those 500 words you should be able to read, thanks Sadhvi for saying yes, within 6 to 9 minutes, and should be able to attempt the questions also. So here my suggestion is that you may just read half the passage or even two-thirds of the passage and then look at the questions also. So simultaneously you will build your understanding that what is going on in the question and what is expected to be answered, so that you can think in that direction. So hence, by the time you are able to complete that passage, you will have an understanding developed about the passage as well as what is expected to be answered. So here you should try to then completely focus, develop the understanding of the situation, and then try to answer it. And here reading comprehension can be a great opportunity for those who may have a little fear of quantitative aptitude. So once you have the reading comprehension, and you'll notice these are quite popular passages about some personalities, like here we are talking about Sachin Tendulkar in the passage 1, then we are talking about the issue of ragging in the passage 2, and there we talked about Soviet Union in the passage 3. So you'll find something related that you have already heard, or then which is in news already. Like in the 4th passage we talked about carbon emission. So we all have somewhere read, somewhere discussed these issues. So hence, if you with complete focus try to read it, understand it, and simultaneously look at the questions, then probably you can answer them. And here we expect out of 30 questions you should be able to answer 20 plus questions very easily. If you are able to answer 20 plus questions correctly, that would be adequate enough. Probably in verbal ability you may not be able to answer out of 50 many questions. So even if you are able to answer 25 plus questions in verbal ability, that would be adequate. Based on past data, I'm talking about this. Based on other examinations also, I'm talking about this. Then moving on to section 3, quantitative aptitude, right? Now, quantitative aptitude may be a strong point, very strong point of somebody, may not be so strong point of somebody. So do not worry at all, because we understand that some of you might be working, some of you might not be so good, might not be having that mathematics right now. You would have studied this long back. So quickly, probably to understand this quantitative aptitude, I'm moving to another screen of quantitative aptitude. There we have tried to categorize on what topics, what kind of questions we can expect. So all these topics are up to 10th level. If you are able to revise them, it is very better. If you are able to take some guidance, even some coaching, so that would also be great. These topics include number system. So you may expect this is a tentative figure. So it can be 4 to 5 or 4 to 3 sometimes. Kindly hold on with your question, Sadhvi. We'll answer it, please. Number system will have 4 questions, simplification and algebra, 4, speed, time, distance. Thanks, Sadhvi, for saying okay. Profit, loss and discount, 2, permutation and probability, 3, work and time, percentage, geometry, mensuration, simple interest and partnership, time and work, ratios. So all these areas tentatively are expected. 99% you'll notice that all the questions are out of this only. 1 or 2 maybe some other topic, but related to this, very basic, right? So hence we are talking about the section 3 quantitative aptitude. So here, whatever you have prepared, you should be able to identify easy questions. What are your kind of questions? Prioritize them and try to answer them. Do not stuck with the question. If it is getting so long, move on. And retry at last if time allows. Otherwise, simply apply your guesstimate. Use your approximation skills and elimination method for guesstimate. I hope that would be useful for quantitative aptitude. So whatever topics I shared, out of that you can try to work upon. And you'll notice that questions are of the old type, from easy to moderate to tough to very tough. So we try, this is only, the objective is that we should try to have the spread that who have a little understanding, they are able to have the marks in the average. Who have more understanding, they are above average. Who are intelligent, they should be in the merit list, right? And there should be a spread in the result. I'll show that slide 7 also. Here is slide 7. You wanted to see it in case you want to make any note, Sadhvi. And about that segregation, the quality of questions, you'll notice in the quantitative aptitude, if you look at question number 92, 93, 94, you can consider them in easy category. Then even 98 question can be considered under easy category. Then question 96, 97, or 100 question can be considered under tough category. 101st, 104th can be considered under moderate category. So do not worry that there are not questions of your type, whatever you have prepared. And also we'll upload this video on CL website, so you can have that link, right? The slide with question and section, questions breakup. Sadhvi and everyone, do not worry at all. Whatever interaction we are having right now of this webinar, this complete video would be available on YouTube through Career Launcher. So anytime you can search, maybe by tomorrow or day after, complete video would be available. So anytime you can go back and pause it and at your convenience watch it again. Okay, thanks for responding, Sadhvi. Thanks, Gundeep. So I'll answer, Swaroop, to your question, how many mocks will be provided. By IBSAT, we are providing 4 mock tests. We are providing 4 mock tests in addition to this. So one you are already given, 4 more would be there, and in total 5 mocks you can attempt. And if you are attempting it seriously, that would be a great practice, and we'll also be sharing the keys, so that you can verify how many you attempted correctly. And first mock, I'm going to share the key here, right? Probably you may not be able to note all the answers, but in the video on YouTube, soon you'll find this video on YouTube. You'll be able to check the answers. Rishabh, in case you didn't receive any mock paper, we'll provide the information how you can get those mock papers at the last. Kindly park with your questions. Hopefully, I'll be able to answer those. Yeah, that is a good question. What is a good number of attempts in quantitative aptitude? Quantitative aptitude, Pratik, I was going through certain cutoffs of IIFT. Although we do not have cutoffs, sectional cutoffs in this IBSAT, IIFT, their cutoffs are as low as 15%. On an average, they say it is 25%. Like in quantitative aptitude, they say if you are able to answer 6 questions out of 25, so it's sufficient enough. General awareness, they expect just 2 questions out of 20. Data interpretation also 25%. So here, a good number of attempts is that at IBSAT, out of 30 questions in quantitative aptitude, if you are able to attempt 15 plus, so you can consider yourself in the average category, right? In reading comprehension, like we were expecting 20 plus, Here you can consider, since you are not in touch, probably reading comprehension, you can understand better and answer it. There you can expect 15 plus. Then I hope this is fine with everyone, quantitative aptitude. Then moving to data interpretation part and data sufficiency. Here you'll see that part one, that is 15 questions. This is about data sufficiency, right? If you look at the question paper, starting from 111 to 125, these 15 questions are on data sufficiency, whether the data is sufficient. Yeah, Sadhi, I'll answer your question. Okay, maybe I can answer it now also, that the time has increased, but sorry, time is not increased, questions have increased. Yes, we have increased the questions. Last year there were 120 questions, now there are 140. Reason being that they were trying to divide that 120 into four equal time parts, because verb ability, either you know or you don't know. So to balance that timings, to balance optimization, so that you have the set 30 minutes planned for each, we have kept 50 questions in verb ability, and we expect you to complete those 50 questions within 30 minutes time frame. Hope that answers your question, Sadhvi. Okay, thanks for responding. So in the data interpretation part, you kindly try to remember this. What are the option A, what is option B, what is option C, what is option D, what is option E? Because most likely 99%, these will be the same options. So you must have this. If you have this in mind, you will be able to answer it easily, these 15 questions quickly. A is first statement is correct, B is second statement is correct, is sufficient, C is they together are sufficient to answer the question, D is either of the statement can answer the question, and the E is none of the question. So if this is there in your mind, then please do re-verify before responding, and hence while answering each and every question, you won't be required to go through that ABCDE, and you will be able to simply respond as ABCDE. So in this way you can answer data adequacy and interpretation. Then you will see some sections of this that will be based on some trend of time series, like what was the trend in 2003, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and there are some questions on line, there are some questions on pie chart. So there also, in case you are not able to handle many questions in quantitative aptitude, everyone kindly pay your attention. Here is the opportunity. And if at present also you are not able to respond to many questions of data interpretation, kindly practice this more. Here, chances of improvement are faster, quicker, in very limited time. So hence, you can significantly score here if by chance you used to lack some areas of quantitative aptitude. And here, probably you may like this. This is the key to the model mock paper that you have already attempted of IBSAT. I'm just showing the screen, and in case if you are able to take a quick photo of this, you can keep that with you. Otherwise, this would be video available on YouTube, and you can rewatch this and verify how many you are able to answer properly, how many you are not able to answer properly. So moving on, I have already shared the topic-wise breakup of section 3. Of section 1, those 50 questions, the breakup is synonyms and antonyms. I have 10 questions, word relation of 5, error spotting in a particular statement 10, phrase replacement, one word substitution again 10, fill in the blanks 10, jumbled sentences 5. So these all together makes the section 1 complete. Then section 2, you'll find 4 passages in this. Then on an average, if you spend 6 to 8 minutes to answer a passage, of 500 words limit with 5 to 6 questions each or 5 to 8 questions each, you will be able to handle it well. Then moving on to this, I already answered data adequacy and data interpretation. Probably this also I have shared, but again, out of 30, you'll find data sufficiency, there will be 15 questions. Data interpretation based on pie chart of 5, then line plus table of 5, then a trend. This DI should be a trend. That trend, like year wise trend or some other trend, based on that, you'll be required to respond to it. This will also be a 5. So here you have more chances to improve upon if you fear quantitative aptitude. So these were the details about the IBSAT model paper that you already appeared. Then moving on to more information that most of you are in between asking. So since there are 9 campuses at one place, Hyderabad, which is a deemed university, it's the same examination that you'll be appearing in IBS Hyderabad. The qualifying ways are IBSAT. The exam you will be going through between 10th to 30th of December, or CAT score or GMAT score. The fee for 2 years is 12,20,000. The complete process includes IBSAT, / CAT, / GMAT, that will make the qualifying, and group discussion / PI. This will be the process for the MBA program once you report there in February. The weightage for both IBSAT, kindly pay your attention here, this is very important. There is no weightage to the total score. This is only a qualifying examination. All of you who will be able to qualify this will be at the same level. Main the entrance or the admission score, based on which you will be allocated your campus of choice, will be out of the second round. The second round will be having group discussion, personal interview, plus your academic performance. So if you are able to qualify IBSAT well enough, or if you are having a CAT score of 2014 of at least 60 percentile, and GMAT, any score of GMAT 2011 onwards is accepted. Kindly note this, GMAT, any score 2011 onwards is accepted. There you should have 500 plus score. Pratik, I'll come to your answer. Kindly wait. Most of you have already applied for IBSAT. If you're not applied, the last date for IBSAT is 1st of December. There are 4 days to go. If you have not applied, you are interested in applying for IBS. Once that last date is crossed, you won't be able to apply for it. So apply by 1st of December. And in case you have already 60, Lonika and everyone, kindly wait for cutoff score for qualifying IBSAT. I'll answer it. One sec. Last date for applying with CAT, GMAT would be 31st of December. If you have already scored 500 plus in GMAT or 60 percentile plus in CAT, then you can apply by December 31st. So once you are qualified, and coming to the qualifying, like last year, there were 25,000 applicants who appeared in IBSAT examination, and we had invited top 20,000 for appearing in the interview. So similarly, this cutoff is not fixed. This may vary depending upon how many are able to reach that qualifying score level. So it may vary. I'll come to that. Kindly answer. Allow me to answer that question first. So whosoever are in that top range, last year out of 25,000, 20,000 were qualified, 20,000 were invited for appearing in the group discussion and personal interview. Sadhvi, hope that answers your question. So cutoff may vary year to year. Yeah, thanks for responding. Here, because you understand, in any of the entrance examination of CAT, we are not about absolute mark. We consider the percentile, and the above percentile as per the qualifying that come into that category will be invited for appearing in the group discussion and personal interview. And when you are in the final selection process, past academic record is already there, will have weightage of 40 marks, 16 for graduation, 12 marks for 10th, 12 marks for 12th. This is completely transparent. You already scored out of that. GD group discussion, whatever you'll score would be out of 30. Personal interview will be out of 30. This mark, whatever you are scoring, will disclose this. Will not disclose IBSAT marks. Kindly keep this in mind, because there more marks or less marks are not important. There it is only important that whether you have qualified or not. For example, if you apply for a loan from bank, whether you'll get a loan or you'll not get a loan, only that is important. And if you have applied through IBSAT, you can submit your CAT score through the login provided. If you also the CAT score, you can submit it through login provided. This is only for the analysis purpose, right? Yes, Rishabh Gupta is asking, a good IBSAT score does not ensure us a seat at IBSAT, any of the preferred campus. No, it does not. Kindly keep this in mind, everyone. A good IBSAT score does not ensure you a seat at any campus of your choice. Your selection final IBSAT, but will is a filtration process, right? So you want to see that level of intelligence. If you are above in the qualifying, then everything will be based on not GDPI but plus your academic performance till now, right? Then Sadhvi has this question: can we choose the campus preference or is it according to the score? Yes, you can choose your campus preference, but you should have that adequate score also, right? So it will be a match. It will be matching what campuses you are preferring. Say, suppose at a campus we have 500 seats. You are also preferring it, and above you there are 550 people who are preferring it, and they have even better marks than you. Then you will not get this campus. But if you are able to score in that 500 range for preferring, so you'll get that campus. Hope it answers your query, Sadhvi. And analysis, Sadhvi, question one by one, please. Allow me to answer first and then shoot next question. Analysis means we only try to analyze how you're scoring in IBSAT and how you're performing in CAT. So we just try to correlate between both the scores. It's only for internal. It won't affect your performance in the admission test. And one more thing, although everyone kindly hold on with your questions. I'll respond to each and every one. Although it does not ensure your seat at any of the campuses, the IBSAT score, but if you are able to perform well, then it is quite likely that you'll perform well in group discussion and personal interview also. And if you have a good academic record, that would be an added advantage. And then hopefully you'll get your campus of choice. Then Lonika has this question: if I don't qualify IBSAT but get 60 percentile up in CAT, then can I update? Yes, you can. Yes, you can. You'll be eligible based on CAT score, right? Because we already specified this or this or this. There are three qualifying criteria: IBSAT or CAT or GMAT. So any one of these you are in. We are not saying AND. Hope you understand this quantitative. It's only OR in Venn diagram, the way we use, right? So anywhere you are qualifying, you are in for group discussion and personal round. Okay, thanks for confirming. Tanya is saying, I have heard, sir, that after selection, there are A to J level of examinations. There are no A to J level of examinations, but there are many examinations within a semester. No A to J levels. Probably you have heard it wrong. Sadhvi, what is the average CTC? We are coming to that. We are coming to that. All those details we will share with you. Every information is there. Tanya, there's no sectional cutoff. Probably you joined late or you missed in between. There's no sectional cutoff. So overall, whatever you'll score, that will contribute whether you qualify or you do not qualify. Then specialization offers, we have specializations, marketing, HR, finance, operations, IT, and each and every campus, depending upon the sufficient number of students who are interested in having that specialization. At IBS Hyderabad, there are 1,000 seats. So if you prefer it and you are having that score in that merit of top 1,000, you will get it. Then Sadhvi, you had this question of average CTC. So not just Hyderabad, of all the campuses I'm sharing. And we have this information of, so you can look at the trend of 2012, 2013, and till now, whatever have got the placement of last year, or 2014, right? So probably, although it is sufficient information, if you read on the screen, that will suffice, but still, to have a trend, Hyderabad was 5.8, 2604, then average package in 2014 was 6. Top 10% got 10 lakhs. Then top 25% was 7.8. Similarly, is the salary detail of all the campuses. You can kindly read. There are campuses, for example, Pune, that was from 6 to 6.04 till 9.52. Gurgaon 5 to 5.11. Now top 10% is 10.96. Average 25% is 7.40. So you may go through it. Rishabh has this question. Is it necessary to select the exam in our IBSAT profile based on which we are applying for IBSAT? Yes, it is necessary, Rishabh. The fee, Sadhvi has this question, whether it includes the hostel facility. It does not, Sadhvi, because hostel facility is only available at IBS Hyderabad, that is a residential campus. Thanks for responding, Rishabh. Hyderabad is a residential campus. Others have the PG arrangements, but we do not have in-campus residential facility. So in it, each and every place where you would reside, whether it is PG or hostel facility, that will be paid extra, right? It's not included in the fee. Fee is only for this curriculum, not the hostel. Then you may be interested. I'll come to your question, Swaroop. Top 10% and top 25% selected on which criteria? Like, every year when students are recruited, so top 10% of the packages, say highest package is 21 lakhs, when you notice here, 21.6 lakhs in 2014 at Gurgaon. So then going a little down, say there are 500 students. So what is the average of top 50% of the students? Like we say at Hyderabad, we have the seats for 1,000 students. So when we say top 10% means top 100. 25% means top 250 students who are getting the highest salary packages. So I hope that suffice, the query. Sadhvi has this question. Sir, can you please let me know, according to the data provided, it seems that Pune campus should be the right choice. Sadhvi, it's your choice, not our choice. So there are many things one has to see. City, area, recommendations from friends, right? So it's high involvement decision. Although it's not a class, but still I would like to share. This is not low involvement decision that I say and you go for it. It's high involvement decision that you take more data, see your performance, and decision has to be taken in February. There's a lot of time. Keep on taking data, and at that time, based on your performance, based on the options you receive, after that you kindly decide. Hope that answers your question, Sadhvi. There's a question, kindly do your homework. That homework is very important because it's high involvement decision. Take recommendations of your parents, recommendations of even some of the alumni. Pratik has this question, what are the seats in each and every campus? There are sufficient number of seats, Pratik, each and every campus. Like at Gurgaon, there are 500 students right now. In 1 year, 500 in another year. At Hyderabad, there are 1,000 in 1 year. So sufficient number of seats are there. It depends that how much you score and what is your preference. Based on that, you'll get the seat of your choice. Then Ashutosh has this question, what is the lowest placement at Hyderabad? At Hyderabad, Ashutosh, the lowest placement was 4 lakhs of CTC 4 lakhs. Does having work experience helps in a good salary placement? Certainly, Swaroop, because if you have work experience, then it is quite likely that you'll appear well in, perform well in group discussion, personal interview right now. So your chances of getting admission increases, although there's no direct weightage. Please keep this in mind. Having work experience is not having any direct weightage, but when you do well in personal interview, you do well in GD, you automatically get the weightage. Then also at the time of placements, I would like to share my experience here, because when the people from industry, HR manager comes, they simply say that if somebody is fresh, right, so they'll have to give them a lot of training, how to behave, in initial level, the corporate culture and all that. Whereas having work experience, there's an added advantage. So they can simply start contributing to the corporate. So that will certainly be having that added advantage if you have work experience. Tanya now is saying that I don't have a work experience, feel it be a drawback. Tanya, can you have a work experience overnight, right? Because you want to do it MBA right now. But yes, if you are able to do the course seriously, and then there is a USP of IBS that we send you to the corporate for summer internship program for 14 weeks, which is equivalent to 4 months. So during that 4 months, if you do it very seriously and get that experience, then you will be equally good, and even some freshers are performing better, right? These higher salaries are not necessarily of the work experience people. Even equally, there are many who were freshers. So do not worry on that. Right, Tanya? Then moving on, fee structure for each and every campus. Like we said, for Hyderabad, the fee structure is 12.20 for 2 years. So if you categorize this into, thanks for responding, Tanya. If you categorize this into, divide this into yearly basis, per annum it would be 6.1. Then Dehradun, Jaipur, per annum it is 2.5. Other PGPM campuses, Ahmedabad, Bangalore, Gurgaon, Kolkata, Mumbai, Pune, this is 3.55. Means for 2 years total, it is 7.10 for all these 6 PGPM campuses. So that is the fee structure. Then In addition, students have to pay 10,000 as a refundable caution deposit with the first installment of tuition fee. And this does not include the hostel facility. For hostel, you'll have to pay it separately. Rishabh has this question: what is the best rank IBS Hyderabad has scored in 2012-13 survey for best boys school in India conducted by any national media agency? Rishabh, IBS has always been in top 20, including IIMs, right? In private, it has been in top 20, including IIMs, it has been in top 50. IBS Hyderabad. So it is consistent in its performance. Sadhvi has this question, sir, does IBS have any tie-ups with different banks for sanction of loans? Yes, Sadhvi, IBS has tie-ups with various banks. You'll notice that they'll help you in getting the loan approved. Thanks, Rishabh, for saying okay. These banks include HDFC Bank, Credila Financial Services, Avanci Financial Services Private Limited. When we'll send you the link kit now of IBSAT, and also after completing your this is not the end of this interaction. Please keep this in mind. Webinar is this is not the end. It's just a beginning that we are interacting, especially on Thanksgiving Day. So I again thank you for listening patiently and questioning one by one. So we'll be having a brief briefing section, selection briefings close to your city. Selection briefings are going to be held in the first week of February. From 1st to 10th, you'll notice that you'll receive the selection briefings information where you can go personally and attend. All these informations related to loan, etc., are there in the selection process 2014 kit, right? And here we are interacting in audio for more queries, although I'll be taking some more queries right now. More queries, we have planned selection briefings from February 1st to 10th. So we'll send you that information. And all that information will be available on website. These selection briefings we have planned in 50 cities across the country, right? Kindly wait, Rishabh, I'm coming to your question also. So there you can have face-to-face interaction with IBS faculty members, right? You'll notice that very senior faculty members would be visiting. Even I would be visiting at Lucknow for 2 days. I'll be there. Some other senior faculty members would be visiting at those 50 cities. So you can have face-to-face interaction, and more queries you can have, you can have the answer to that, right? You can respond to that while interacting face-to-face. Even you can invite your parents along with. They can also go and attend and raise your queries. Rishabh has this question, are there any scholarship schemes awarded by IBS? Rishabh, there are no scholarship schemes, right? Also, we are not providing you the laptop. Laptop also you'll have to purchase yourself of your likes or dislikes, and you can carry on to the classroom. Then, what are the important topics for group discussion? Is it based on current affairs, current happening, general topics? Yes, Archana, you already answered your question. It is very much based on the current affairs, current happenings. Look into the news, like we were talking about carbon emissions in passage. We were talking about Sachin Tendulkar. So whatever is happening around, you may find that topic in group discussion. And when I was saying that our next interaction with each other would be in selection briefings, face-to-face interaction. For that selection briefings, you can visit nearby IBS office. Even this information is there on the website. So you'll be able to have that information, and please do visit that selection briefings individually or with your parents. GD and PI will be only held in Hyderabad or any other cities also. Ashutosh, please note that group discussion, personal interview, we invite you to visit Hyderabad only. So it will be only held in Hyderabad, no other city. And this selection process dates are already decided. So any day of your convenience and of the availability of accommodating the number of students, any date between 18 to 26, February 2015, you'll be invited, subject to the condition you clear the qualifying examination if set. Yes, Sadhvi, interviews will be held only in Hyderabad. Thanks for responding, Archana. Thanks for responding, Ashutosh. More queries are welcome. Hope I have answered most of your queries. So on Thanksgiving Day, I'm saying thanks again and again for another four mock tests. Like, some of you had this query, probably you liked this IBSAT test. So you can again participate in the remaining four tests which are available, which can be taken by sending an email. Some of you were not able to give IBSAT mock test, so probably you had this regret. So just send an email to online@ibsatindia.org. So they'll provide you the link with all the information. So you can give this IBSAT mock test, and you don't have to pay anything at all. And for IBSAT mock test, and hopefully maybe we'll have more interaction on that IBSAT mock test analysis also. Then website detail is given, toll free number is given, no more queries are coming. In case any last moment query. So again, thanks for joining. Wish you all the best in IBSAT examination and your career further. Thanks for joining. Thank you very much.